Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and this past week was filled with information about a March Apple event, and then that we might not have one, as well as foldable iPhone news, iOS 15 information, and more. And so this is the news update for the week of February 21st, 2021. And so the first thing is, for the first time in quite some time, about 4 years, according to Gartner, Apple overtook sales when it comes to phones against Samsung. So iPhone has long been against Samsung as far as some of the leaders, and apparently Apple has overtaken them in their overall sales of the iPhones in the last quarter of 2020. So I thought that was kind of interesting news. We haven't seen that in a while, so that's good news if you're an Apple user. And the next thing has to do with some small news about Apple Maps. So if you use Apple Maps and you're in the United Arab Emirates, you'll now have access to turn-by-turn navigation. So if you go into Maps, so now you have access to turn-by-turn navigation like this, but you won't have speed limits or lane guidance, unfortunately, maybe a little bit later, and there's still no public transit information, but at least you have turn-by-turn, and in my use of Apple Maps, I've actually found that it's quite good, and in sometimes better than Google Maps when it comes to newer locations. It seems to be updated more quickly, at least in my use. Now, the Apple event that many people, including myself, mentioned last week that supposedly would happen around March 16th, according to iHacktuPro and then later confirmed by Mark Gurman, has said that it will not be happening on the 16th. Now, that doesn't mean we won't have an event later in the month, but on the calendar, generally last year on the 16th, which is a few weeks away, we could see maybe some product announcements, but don't expect an actual event. Last year, Apple actually introduced the iPads Pro, a Magic Keyboard, and the MacBook Air via press releases in March. So maybe we'll see something similar to that, or maybe we won't. But at this point, it looks like there's no event on the 16th, maybe something a little bit later with some new iPads Pro, maybe new AirPods as well. I'll talk about those in a moment. Now, also, Mark Gurman said, don't expect AirTags on March 16th either. However, no one is confirming whether or not we'll have those later in the month so we can locate our devices with AirTags. The code is still in iOS 14.4 and 14.5, so I guess we'll just have to wait and see when it comes to that. Now, when it comes to the iPhone, there's some news about that as well. And the first thing is, if you have an iPhone, Apple apparently will no longer have to replace the entire device if you crack the back glass. According to an internal memo, according to Mac Rumors, Apple will now have the ability to swap parts of the device instead of the entire device costing you a lot more. So according to Mac Rumors, they said Genius Bars and Apple authorized service providers will have a new iPhone rear system part available to them that consists of the rear enclosure, the iPhone itself, of course, its components, except the display and rear cameras would not be included. However, it would have the battery, the logic board, the haptic engine, Face ID, and anything else that's needed. So they'll have different parts available so they could swap existing parts more quickly. I personally would just like to have them swap the whole device since it's sealed at the factory, but it looks like they won't have to do that. Now, when it comes to iPhone 13, patently Apple has found a new patent for a variable refresh rate display that can adjust not only from 60 hertz to 120, but also 180 and up to 240 hertz. So it would have a variable refresh rate that can go all the way from 60 to 240, and there's something new about it that Apple found the reason to patent. So apparently there's a patent, and it's looking more and more likely that we'll have a variable refresh rate display with iPhone 13 or 12S or whatever Apple calls this. Also, iPhone 13, due to those adjustments, is said to be bringing an always-on display. Now, according to some, this is a hardware feature, and unfortunately, we may not see this with, say, future versions of iOS, but rather because the hardware is different and can vary the refresh rates, it could save power, just like it does on the Apple Watch with its variable refresh rate. So it dims when you put your wrist down and sort of goes to sleep into a very low hertz mode to save power with an always on display. It makes sense that Apple would have this, but it'll be unfortunate to not have it on all phones, and it'll be a reason to upgrade, I suppose. Now, according to another patent by patently Apple, there's also dual screen iPhones that have been patented by Apple. Now, whether that means a foldable phone or just a screen on the back, maybe a little notification here, or maybe relating to a clamshell phone where it could fold and have a display in the corner and then your foldable display inside, is hard to say, but Apple has a patent for that nonetheless. And also, Omdia has said that Apple is still working on a foldable phone, that it would be about 7.3 to 7.6 inches inches. It'll be an OLED display with maybe even Apple Pencil support. So maybe we'll have Apple Pencil support on that foldable iPhone, which would make it more like an iPad and seems to make more sense than maybe on an iPhone. But also, according to Digitimes, LG is working closely with Apple to make this display. So many people had suspected it would be Samsung, and it still could be Samsung, but maybe LG has something a little bit different that they don't, or maybe they just have excess capacity that Samsung doesn't. But either way, this may not launch until 2023. So it could be quite some time before we see a foldable phone, but Apple's at least working on it, whether it be clamshell like this, where it would fold, or be more like Samsung's where it folds this way. It's hard to say, but they could be working on something like that. Now, according to Mark Gurman, reverse wireless charging is not coming to an iPhone anytime soon. We have that ability on Samsung phones, but iPhones don't have it. However, according to FCC filings, all the iPhone 12 lineup phones have the ability to reverse wireless charge. So it's kind of strange that we don't have the option, even if it's there. Maybe we're waiting for new MagSafe accessories for, say, AirPods, for example, but we don't have the ability to have it, and we may not have it for quite some time. So that's sort of unfortunate, but it does look like Apple is working on a battery pack of some kind based on code found in iOS 14.5. So for those of you that really want a battery pack, Apple did come out with some interesting accessories like this for the iPhone, where you take the iPhone out, put it back in, and now we have a sleeve for the iPhone. I have another video on this specifically, but you've got the sleeve, and this is an odd accessory, so why not have an accessory with a battery pack that's MagSafe capable that will allow it to charge your phone just like MagSafe, where it adheres to the back, maybe magnetically. Whether it's a case or not, I'm not sure, but it would be nice to have that option in the future for a battery pack. So 14.5 appears to reference some sort of battery pack. Hopefully we'll see something like that. Now, as far as when to expect iOS 14.5 beta 3, well, I would say as soon as tomorrow if we're on a 1 week cycle, or it could be the following week if we're still on a 2 week cycle. Based on what Apple's done year over year, they've had up to 7 betas at some points. So we could see more betas, but then based off iOS 14.4, we could have a public release this week as well with iOS 14.5, since 14.4 only had 2 beta releases. So right now, Apple's schedule seems to be a little bit different than what we've had in the past. So hopefully we'll see something soon, but I would expect some sort of beta or maybe even a public release this week. But at this point, things are up in the air and not really similar to what they've done in previous years with iOS 13, iOS 12, iOS 11, any of those. If you look back at what they've done, this year is not anything like that. So don't expect public releases the same way, I suppose, at this point. Even though they stopped signing iOS 14.3, it's been more than 2 weeks, and generally we would have a public release by now. So I would expect something soon, but there's no guarantee at this point, since it seems Apple has changed whatever sort of release schedule they had in the past. Now, as far as iOS 15, iHacktuPro, which seems to be fairly accurate with some of these leaks when it comes to iOS specifically, has said to expect a new lock screen, new control center with iOS 15, as well as more interactive widgets and maybe some different sizes, according to some tweets, and possibly split view for multitasking. Now, whether or not we see this is hard to say. It's some of it I've said I'd like to see in iOS 15. I would like to see a redesigned control center. I actually prefer the older style where they slid up from the bottom and sort of covered part of the screen. However, the newer version is a little bit more functional since iOS 12 or so, but I prefer the older one a little bit more myself. But in general, I think we'll see at least some modifications to that. And always on display on the lock screen makes sense, as well as more interactive widgets where we can interact with these a little bit better. Seems to make a lot of sense. So hopefully we'll have something that's a little bit better with iOS 15 as far as that goes. Now, 52 Audio has given us a recent leak of what appears to be AirPods 3. So they're similar to AirPods Pro in a way, but they're also different in that they don't have removable tips at the end or noise cancellation, at least what it looks like from these pictures. So it looks like the case is a little bit smaller, and it also may maintain the touch controls that we have on the AirPods Pro, where you can press and hold to change between transparency or noise cancellation. Instead, we can use it for changing music tracks, things like that. And will have something like that fairly soon. It looks like these match what other people have leaked before, and they match what other people have said before to expect with the next AirPod. So I would look forward to those. Now, I did want to show you one other thing as well from Antonio De Rosa. I showed you a concept last week of his Apple glasses, but he made this concept showing what an Apple cryptocurrency wallet could look like. So it would be a really interesting sleek wallet if cryptocurrency takes off to be the main way of paying for things. It could look something like this. So I thought maybe it would be something interesting that you would enjoy. He makes a lot of great concepts, so I'll link him in the description. So if you want to check out the other works he's had as well, but let me know if you think Apple should do their own cryptocurrency and what you think an Apple wallet would look like. And finally, Apple has released a new security website updating how all of their security works. So Apple Platform Security, you've got a table of contents here that talks about everything from encryption and data protection to app security, and helps you understand how they do things, how their hardware is secure, and more. So I'll link that in the description as well if you want to check that out. But it's got a lot of information about security, how they do it, how you should secure your apps as well. And so that's it for this week with the news. A lot of information about upcoming iPhones, and I'm really looking forward to the next version of iOS, and hopefully iOS 14.5 soon. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.